What's up, guys? It's Sablehound. With the return of the game mode Control to Black Ops Cold War, it has quickly become my favorite game mode. But I find myself frequently explaining to teammates how it's played, and I know there aren't very many videos on the subject, so today I'll be providing a brief overview along with some tips on the game mode Control in Black Ops Cold War. Let's jump into the basics. Control is an amalgam of previous game modes in Call of Duty, with its domination-like objective of capturing an area on the map, the large size of the objective area, like in Hardpoint, and the limited lives and round-based nature of Search and Destroy. In Control, best of 5 rounds or first to 3 wins the map. Each round will alternate between offense and defense. The objective on offense is to either capture the 2 stationary zones on the map, or depleting the opposing team's allotment of lives before the time runs out. Basically, either cap or kill. On defense, your objective is to either defend and prevent your opponents from capturing both of your zones or depleting their lives. The zones are located in the same place every game, every round. Each team of 6 starts off with a shared bank of 30 lives, and you'll respawn until only 6 remain. If you die after all of your team's lives are depleted, you cannot respawn until the next round, when the bank is replenished, starting again at 30 lives. So value your life because it affects the entire team. Don't be the guy that wastes the team's lives. If you're only down to a few, play it slow and be methodical. Especially when you're on defense and you're out of lives, the other team needs to either kill you or capture both zones, so play your life while running the clock out. The initial time limit on a round is 1 minute and 30 seconds. Once offense captures one zone, the zone disappears from the map for the rest of the round, and an additional 1 minute is added to the clock. When a zone is being captured or contested, the time pauses, so if you're on offense and the time is running down, do your best to contest the zone. Sometimes you gotta play like a rat, just pause the clock until reinforcements arrive. Uncontested, it takes 1 minute for one player to capture a zone. For 2 players, the time is cut in half to 30 seconds. Add a third, and that time is reduced by a third, and so on. Essentially, the more teammates you have helping you capture a zone, the less time it takes. While we were testing this in a private match, we were able to get it down to 15 seconds. So sometimes a good strategy is to flood a zone, quickly capture it, and move on. A zone capture is segmented into thirds. While you're capturing the zone, the segments are indicated by the 3 bars on the top of your screen. When a segment is captured, you'll see a partial capture notification rewarding you with 250 points. You can still check on the status of a zone at any time and anywhere on the map by just looking in the general direction of a given zone, where you'll see the triangle label. Each side of the triangle signifies one segment, and it also indicates its capture status or progress. Keep in mind that a captured zone will disappear entirely, so if you're only seeing one label, there's only one zone left. As soon as one segment is captured, the progress is cemented. However, if the offensive team partially captures any segment, the defensive team can reclaim or cancel out the progress of that segment. For example, if offense has captured 2.5 segments, the defensive team can reclaim only that partial segment, leaving just 2 segments captured and setting the other team back. So on defense, make sure you're reclaiming any progress you can in order to buy yourself more time. When you or your teammates are either capturing or defending a zone, and by defending I mean the technical definition of standing inside of the zone's perimeter will change color, indicating to both teammates and opponents that a player is currently in that zone. The zone perimeter will indicate blue for teammates, red for opponents, and white when it's vacant. So when you're approaching a zone, note the perimeter color. If it's red, get ready for a gunfight. Blue, a teammate is occupying it. And if it's white, still approach with caution because chances are an opponent is in the vicinity or watching over the zone. Same goes for defense. Be cognizant that if you are recapturing or defending a zone, the perimeter will indicate your presence. So if you have no need to be inside of the zone, try to defend it from the outside of the perimeter to prevent tipping off your opponents. Control is different from other respawn modes in that you cannot completely flip spawns, although you can still manipulate them. You'll generally spawn on the same side of the map, opposite to the other team, but the spawn can vary, of course, based on your opponent's location. So if your strategy is to pick off enemy lives in their spawn, be wary that pushing up too far in a lane could risk spawning them closer to the zone and giving them easier access to it. If you'd like us to do a strategy deep dive on a specific map, let us know in the comments and we'll cover the most requested map first. That about does it for the basics of Control. This game mode is so much fun. I'm so glad it's back. I think it offers the best aspects of respawn and the strategy of search and destroy. If you found the video helpful and want to support the channel, please consider liking, subscribing, and sharing. You can also find us on Instagram and TikTok. Links are in the description below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.